So first one would be definitely get an early start in the morning. The earliest, the better. You beat the sun, you beat the crowds most likely.
But it's just kind of nice to be able to get some of those hours out of the way, you know, without having to get stuck in the middle of it for all of the hike.
Tip number two.
Pack a lot of water. I mean, really pack a lot of water. The way somebody had explained it to me in the past was, imagine that you come across somebody else who needs one.
Yeah.
And if you wanted to be able to help them out without getting both of yourself in trouble, like that's how much extra water you should pack all the time. I think we both have 3-liter bladders that we put in our bag. And then we both were like carrying around like extra 1-liter bottles on the other side. And we had another water bottle in our bag.
Yeah.
It was a lot, but it's better to have a little bit extra water at the end than it is to have none. And that's obvious. But really, when you're looking yourself in the eye before you leave, tell yourself to grab another.
You don't want to depend on anyone. You want to have your own water, enough water for you, and then he wants to have enough water for him. Have room for extra. Have room in case you go off trail and you lose the, you don't know where you're going, and then you have to be out there longer than planned. So water is very important.
There are noon tablets out there that we like. There are other tablets like these as well, like that you can just drop into your water. We obviously put some stuff in our bladder. We don't put any additives into our bladder, but we usually have the bottles on the side. We'll throw some of those tablets into, and they're good because when you're hiking, you will sweat, and you'll sweat out a lot of sodium, a lot of your salt too, so you do want to be able to replace that. Otherwise you might get those little spots in your eyes if you stand up too fast or something.
Yeah.
So not only do you want to drink water, but make sure that you get yourself some of the electrolytes or some of the other tablets even with a little bit of sodium in there. Sometimes salty snacks make you thirsty, and you don't want to put too much water in, because you might actually be carrying around a big old bladder of water inside your body now, and that could feel weird. But make sure you put those tablets in. It's not just water. You kind of want some of those minerals and nutrients too.
So that's the noon tablets that Alex is talking about. It's just like a regular tablet. You throw it into your water bottle, and it's going to provide you with the necessary sodium, amount of sodium. Yeah, and they come with different flavors. So this one is the fresh lime. There are all type of flavors that you can think about. So tip number three, this is something that I learned throughout the years just from hiking out, is you see right now it's really hot outside, but I got everything covered, like wearing long sleeves and protecting your skin. I mean, I'm wearing my long pants.
Yeah, we're both wearing pants.
Yeah, so we both are wearing pants. I mean, it's tempting to want to wear tank tops and t-shirts. Sometimes I feel the same way too. You want to look cute and have some nice cute outfits, but it doesn't work like that when it's really hot outside. And I've experienced it once in South Dakota because it was really hot and I just wanted to show off my skin. But really, on top of sunscreen, which is very important, covering your skin with long sleeves, long pants. And even for Alex, he has a special hat.
If you've followed some of our kayaking stuff, this is the one I wear kayaking though. But it's got a hat, and then it's got these little floppy guys that I can either button up in front of me here if I wanted to. Let's see if I can't do it. All right, so sometimes if the wind's blowing, it'll still kind of keep me in this little area.
Yeah.
Or I can just let it flop around like a big dog with wet floppy ears. Or I can button it up in the back too if I want to kind of keep it out of the way, but I still want that protection. Keeps the sun off your neck, kind of like a buff would, and off the side of my face. I think the buffs are another good substitute. For me though, I usually had like a full brim hat, but still, like if I tilt it forward or backwards or the sun starts to set, I was still getting burnt on my neck. So we figured we'd give this one a try today, and I gotta be honest, it worked out pretty well.
Yes.
And if you have sunscreen, put it on at the interval that they recommend. I'm usually pretty bad about that. I usually am wearing a long sleeve shirt as well, but I bought some sports sunscreen today, and I gotta be honest, I feel fine, but I was putting it on every 80 minutes like they said. But the rule that people have given me all the time, or the example, was when you're driving down here through the desert, through Arizona, et cetera, and you go past a construction site, they're not all out there in tank tops and
True.
Short shorts. They're all dressed to the top with
Yep.
a full buff, a full hat, jacket, long pants, everything. So keeping that sun off of you, especially if you live out here, because you should only be getting sunburned like maybe once or twice a summer at like the worst.
Mm-hmm.
Like, and out here you could get it every day. And I don't even mean to say that you should be getting sunburned at all, but just have a map. I mean, know where you're going before you get there. All Trails is the one that we use, and I know Habib has had a couple videos out on All Trails and such, but we certainly like All Trails. They've just done a retrofit where some of their user interface has changed. But you can download maps, you can bring them offline. All you need is GPS, so you can turn off your Wi-Fi and your phones, everything. But it's important that everybody has a map in your group too, not
Yep.
just like one person. You get separated,
Yep.
that's a problem. Somebody's phone dies, that's a problem. You wanna be able to be responsible for yourself. So download the map, know where you're going before. These also let you know or let you press a button to alert like a friend or a family member. It just sends them a text and they can go click a link and follow your location.
It's called, it's a new feature. Well, it's fairly, I think it's, it was implemented last year, but it's called Lifeline. And it basically would allow you to let someone know where you're going, which is pretty important. The next tip is, well, during summer here in the desert, you obviously wanna watch out for the rattlesnake. During summertime, it's the right time to come across rattlesnakes. Now, there's someone who reached out to me the other day on Instagram asking me, oh my God, how do you hike in the desert? Are you not afraid of snakes? I mean, when I moved to Arizona, it was, you know, I was always worried about snakes and rattlesnakes, but I really didn't understand back then. With time, we kind of learned that snakes don't want anything to do with you. They are as scared of you as you are of them. And so with rattlesnakes, since they have a rattle, I mean, the way it works when you are hiking, you basically just don't want to startle a rattlesnake. And they do feel the vibrations on the ground when you are walking with your feet or your trekking pole. So they will dodge you. They're not going to come your way if they hear you. The only problem is if you startle a rattlesnake. So the one tip is, especially during summer, is probably avoid putting headphones and just try to listen more and be aware of the sounds around you, because the rattle that the rattlesnake has will make enough noise, believe me. Like one time when I was hiking in the Grand Canyon, I can hear it from far away and we couldn't even see it. The rattle noise is really strong. So that's something to watch out for when you are hiking in the desert, especially in summertime.
Yeah, we come across coyotes and such too, and you can treat it like bear stuff too. Like just make some noise while you're going if you have somebody else, but usually if you're on trail, you won't happen across like any nests or anything like that, because there are usually enough people on those trails that they're not gonna make a home there. But if you're off trail or other things like that too, definitely be aware, because if you stumble across something like that too, we learned, what was it, the baby rattlesnakes, as an example, are a bit of a problem because they're not smart enough yet to know not to just discharge all the venom.
Yeah.
So they're actually worse than the parents. The parents will give you a hit of venom and they'll get out, but the kids will just latch on and they'll just drain themselves, and it's problematic.
So the next tip for hiking in the desert during summer is to obviously, you want to make sure that you have your emergency kit everywhere you go. I try to take it with us. We only have one that we share together. It's probably a good idea for long and strenuous hike to each team member should have their own emergency kit. I mean, each emergency kit is different. This is the one that we have. It's a first aid kit, or I call it emergency kit. Anyway, so first aid kit, it has all of the necessary, you know, gauze and alcoholic wipes and bandage, scissors and an emergency blanket. So all of these are necessary. But on top of that, if you're hiking in this desert, you probably want to have tweezers with you. I think it's important because, I don't know, if you get stabbed by a troya or one of those jumping troya. So if you want to remove the needle, tweezers are going to be very helpful in that scenario.
Yeah, and I'll say even today when we were hiking around, especially when we get to this part of the summer where some plants start to die, sometimes some of those cactus pieces will actually fall off, or maybe other animals might even disturb them in such a way that they fall off, and they'll be sitting right there on the trail, just like a part of cactus. Mm-hmm. That you might not notice. It might be like a little small ball and such, but you step on it, gets stuck to your shoe. Maybe it won't go through the rubber, but then you pick your leg up and now it's on your leg, and then you poke yourself with it.
There's obviously, you want to make sure that you are following the leave no trace. There are 7 principles. I'm going to leave a link in the description box. So we're just going with an assumption that you are following leave no trails. You know the principles and you want to follow them as well. If you are driving to the trailhead, for example, I think it's a good idea to leave some water in your car as well, so that when you finish hiking, you know, you either have a cooler with some extra water just to help you hydrate when you finish hiking. And then the next tip I was thinking about, and that's probably just like a lesson learned from our hike today, is know your limits and know how much your body can handle. You know, don't push yourself more than you should, especially in the desert, especially when it's 100 degrees out or more than 100 degrees out. That's something that I learned today about myself. Obviously, we picked this hike. We try to not hike during summer. I personally don't enjoy it, but this was us training for our Kilimanjaro climb and putting ourselves in situations where we can push forward. And I always advise, you know, people who are new to hiking to avoid it unless it's, I don't know, necessary, or you start very early in the morning. And then just don't push yourself beyond necessary, if that makes sense.
If you have any other areas that that you have a list of to-dos for that you think are region-specific, bring them up. We always go out and travel other places to hike too. You know, there are plenty of other ecosystems that have their own rule set, so.
Well, awesome. Well, thank you so much, guys. Thank you for tuning in, and we will see you on Thursday. We do live streams every Thursday. We change the time from 5 p.m. to 6 p.m., so we'll see you this Thursday, 6 p.m. Thanks, guys, and we'll see you soon on another adventure.
Take care, everybody.
Bye.